Hi, hello dear students, welcome to our channel Maths with Panindra. In this video we are going to discuss some objective circles IIT Foundation Mathematics class 9 and 10. Let us have a discussion. The first question here: if the two circles C1 and C2 have 3 points in common, then which of the following is correct? Whenever C1 and C2 are same circles, that means the question number 1 solution, C1 comma C2 are same circles. As there can be one and only one circle passing through three non-collinear points. So C1 and C2 are the same circles, have 3 points in common means only one and only, that means non-collinear points like this only it will go. Whenever C1, C2 are same circles, so C1 is this circle only and C2 is also this circle only, have 3 points in common means, for this circle 3 points are common, same circle only it will go. So according to the options, second option is the right option. We'll move on to the question number 2, dear students. In the question number 2, which of the following pairs of lines can be parallel? So two tangents to the circle. So first option figure I'm drawing. So two tangents are parallel. Next, two tangents to the circle in this case. Two tangents to your circle. At the same time, go to the second option, two diameters of the circle. So this is the circle. So this is one diameter, this is another diameter. So two diameters. Of a circle. Next, third option, a chord of a circle and a tangent to the circle. Chord, tangent, both you can draw. Circle, this is the chord, this is the tangent. So, a chord and a tangent. So according to the fourth option, two chords of a circle. So one chord, another chord. The circle center. For all circle center will be like this. two chords of a circle. Select the correct answer using the codes given below. So 1, 2 and 3, so two tangents to the circle. So in this which are correct one is two tangents to the circle is correct one. So first statement is correct one. This one is correct. And two diameters of the circle, this is wrong. Why? Because infinite number of diameters we can draw. Like this, number of diameters we can draw, dear students. So that is the reason second statement is wrong. Next, a chord and a tangent. Yes, we can draw one chord, one tangent. A chord of a circle and a tangent to the circle. So this is also correct. One chord, one tangent according to the figure. Two chords of a circle means like this we can draw. So 1, 2, 3 means the chords here. Why I am choosing only 1, 3 and 4? 1, 3 and 4 is there means C option is the right option. 1, 3 and 4. Which of the following pairs of lines can be parallel? Two tangents are parallel. But diameters cannot parallel now. Chord and tangent, both are parallel. Chord, tangent, observe in the figure. Two chords also parallel. That is the reason according to the concept. So 1, 3 and 4 only correct. Now we'll move on to the question number 3. In the question number 3, three circles with equal radii touch each other externally. The figure formed by joining the centers of the circles is. Clearly we can draw that. See here, first three circles we need to draw, dear students. So three circles like this we can. So this is the way you can draw the three circles and their radii or equal radii they are saying. So these are the centers of the respective circles. So join like this way, you will get the triangle. So here also R. So suppose if you take these centers, you can take as the points A, B and C. See what happens also. So here AB is equal to BC is equal to CA is equal to R plus R, that is equal to 2R. So whenever all the lengths are equal means, therefore triangle ABC is an equilateral triangle. I hope you understand, students. Now we will move to the question number 4. In the question number 4, two circles with centers, two non-intersecting circles, centers with A and B. See the circles, we can draw like this. One is inside completely. So this is the circle. So this is a circle A, that means big circle I'm taking. Two circles, two non-intersecting circles, one lying inside the another. So this is the circle, a small circle we observe that in the figure, it is inside, whose diameters A and B. So for the big circle, the diameter is A. So diameter A means from here to here it is half, so it will be A by 2, okay. At the same time, the center of smaller circle is B, center of bigger circle is A. So diameter B means this value is B by 2 only, no? Next, from here to here, CD I am taking. They are asking to find the minimum distance between their circumferences is C. Circumferences means this distance is C, it is given. The distance between their centers. So they are asking to find AB value. Here I will draw here according to figure, dear students. So they are asking to find this result AB. From the figure we can get it as. So from figure we can find out BA is equal to BA, we can write it as from A to C. So from here to here, A to C, that means AC minus BC, we can do, dear students, BC. From the figure you can see. So AC value, how it, what value it comes? AC first, as it is, you write it. Minus BC. BC value. From here to here it is C. From here to here it is anyway B by 2 also. No, this is also B by 2. So CD plus DB. From the figure, CD is equal to small c, BD is equal to small b by 2. Why? Because it is a radius of smaller circle. And AC value. AC value is from here to here it is A by 2, means from here to here also. This figure you can understand, students. So this is also A by 2. So AC value is A by 2 minus CD value B by 2. DB value, sorry, CD value is C. That is B by 2. So we can find out 1 by 2, take common from which is equal to 1 by 2. Here A is